It didn't seem like being a prison at all. وبعد صلاة العصر لقد قاموا بتناول الشاي والبسكوت. لم يبدو بأنه سجن على الإطلاق، ولكن كان يبدو كمعسكر لإغاثة الناس الخارجين من كاركة. Inside the block, one could walk and talk freely. I had desperately craved for this in the past 3 or 4 years. بالداخل المبنى يستطيع الشخص أن يمشي ويتكلم بحرية. لقد اشتقت للكلام، لقد اشتقت لكل هذا، للمشي وللكلام في آخر 3 أو 4 سنوات. The chance to talk to someone. الفرصة لكي أتكلم مع أحد. Just to exercise my newfound freedom. لكي أمارس حريتي التي وجدتها الآن. I kept chatting with Hamid. لقد استمرت واستمرت بالحديث مع حميد. I did not give him an opportunity to speak. لم أعطه وأمنحه فرصة للكلام. I talked greedily. My tongue did not remain still even for a second. من كثر جوعي للكلام لساني لم يتوقف لثانية. Hamid, who knew me well by now, lent me his ear most patiently. I must have repeated the same stories to Hamid several times over, but I wasn't satiated. حتى لدرجة أن كنت أكرر القصة عدة مرات إلى حميد، ولكن لم أشعر بالشبع والرضا. أريد أن أتكلم أكثر لأنني كنت محروم من الكلام في آخر 3 سنوات، وحميد كان يفهمني فكان يستمع إلي بصبر. By the evening, someone from the nearby Indian block came to visit me. I did not recall his name now. في المساء أتى شخص من المبنى الهندي وبدأ ليزورني. لم أتذكر اسمه. As soon as he saw me, he shook my hands and smiled. عندما رآني لقد صافحني وابتسم. الله is a compassionate. الله الرحيم العطوف. He said as if to himself. He inquired if I was the one who had made it to the Kunjika shop. I nodded yes. I know after hearing about you, I went there to see you once, but you were asleep and I did not wake you up. Again, he shook my hands and said, Allah is compassionate. I came here only 2 days ago, a scuffle with a sponsor. لقد أتيت هنا قبل يومين عندما تعاركت مع كفيلي. It is all right. Kunjika will bail me out. He kept talking. Every so often, he would clutch my hand and praise Allah 100 times. كل فترة يصافحني ويشكر الله 100 المرات. I started to weep. لقد بدأت في البكاء. And I don't know why. That's the stranger also wept with me. ولم أعرف لماذا هو هذا الغريب بكى معي. Then praising Allah. حمدنا الله كثيرا. He returned to the block. وعاد إلى المبنى. After that, many others from that block came to visit me. وبعد ذلك الكل عرف قصتي والكل جاء لكي يزورني. No one asked me anything. لم يسألني أحد. They had heard my story from that stranger. لقد استمعوا إلى قصتي من هذا الغريب. They only wanted to see me. إنهم فقط يريدون أن يروني. And they looked at me in amazement. وكانوا ينظرون إلي باندهاش. Some shook my hands and consoled me. البعض صافحني وواساني. Those were in my block also heard my story from those who had visited me. والذي هم في المبنى الذي أعيش فيه سمعوا قصتي أيضا وجاءوا ليزوروني. Breaking away from their group, most of the Malayalis in the block gathered around me. كل الملامد اللي من منطقتي في كيرلا في الهند جاءوا وتجمعوا حولي. Some gazed at me as an alien. البعض حملق في كأنني غريب. Some with wonder والبعض باندهاش. Some with awe والبعض بخشية. Some with pity البعض بشفقة. And a few with suspicion والبعض نوع من الشك. Anyhow I learned that within a few hours I was a topic of a conversation. وخلال ساعات بسيطة كانت موضوع حديثهم حديث الكل. All the Malays in the prison. In the day that followed, many more came to see me and made me speak at length. I did not offend any of them. I fed my insatiable appetite for talking. I minutely revisited every moment of my story a thousand times on my mind, and feet were at length as if we were walking on a burning sand. That evening, as we sat for a dinner after Maghrib, all the Malays in the block were with me. I did not even have anything to give them in return of their love except for some tears.